You guys, you're supposed to de-escalate, not make it worse. Why can't you keep your mouth shut? What is wrong with you?
Nose closed and getting loud with me.
Piece of f***. Don't talk to me like that. Don't you talk to me like that. How dare you insult me?
Wow, really?
How dare you piece of f***. Penny, look at this suit. Looks like it's
nice.
It looks like you got your suit out of the garbage can. After this, you're the homeless person.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Oh my God, a large black man has gotten involved. Did you see how everyone changed in that restaurant as soon as a black male stepped up? I mean, all of the back and forth, and now none of that frightened anybody. Everybody was very quiet. So let's go to the origins of this. Very interesting. This is a throwback Karen moment. I'm really not sure how many Karens were here. I mean, obviously the guy who was aggressive, I can consider him a male Karen. He got out of hand. They did insult what he was wearing after he told him to shut his mouth. And the individual from the establishment said, "You're wearing those clothes and you want to insult me." All right, that's a jab. Okay, I got to get, but the man did just tell you to shut up. All right, so they were kind of going back and forth. This happened on a Father's Day at a prime rib in Beverly Hills. And that's why the other patrons were saying, "Hey, there are children here."
It happened okay? on Father's Day?
It was on a Father's Day throwback. All right, Rick, what are your thoughts here, dear brother?
That's the most amazing plot twist I've ever heard, Doc. Oh my goodness. Like, look, there are times to celebrate, right? I didn't expect that.
Yeah.
I don't really know what else to say. All right, so look. As someone who has worked in restaurants before, I'm continually shown how customers feel so entitled all the time. I worked as a table wiper, I boxed pizzas, I answered phones, I served customers. Yeah, at times we saw some crappy ones. But to see something like this, where the staff is being so professional, aside from the jab about his clothes, warranted. It was a soft jab. It was like if Winky Wright was like, "All right, round one, I'm just gonna throw one out there." Like, it's very, very soft. It's nothing. This reminded me, I don't know if you remember, of the New York bagel shop guy. It just looked like he grew a few inches and then grabbed some oversized clothes and just went after the wait staff for no reason. And this dude with the wait staff is being so patient. You know, he had his hands behind his back. And look, I don't know where this was, don't really care. The fact that it was on Father's Day is juicy as hell. And hopefully, you know, he'll go to Outback instead of wherever this is.
Yeah, and you know, it's interesting, man, because we have a simple philosophy here. We defend those who work in our restaurant industry, service-based industries.
Always.
And like you, I've waited tables, I've worked at Pizza Hut, I've worked at Ruby Tuesdays, and I've had these jobs going through college and beyond. And I've always had a deep appreciation for the BS that people in the industry have to take, all right? So interesting, but yeah, it was on a Father's Day.